getting up to?
Nicole's been practicing her TikTok dances. And you are all so amazing at sharing the hashtag #GetBethOnFoodNetwork that Food Network actually rang me up. But of course, I had to decline because of my time commitments.
This week, we're carrying on with our theme of living your best life. And Rachel is going to talk to us about how we do that in healthy relationships.
Hey, wonderful Mr. Youth. So as you can see, I am sat in my car and I'm waiting for my eldest, my 8-year-old, to come out of school. First day back at school, amazing! And Beth, in her wisdom, has asked me to talk about relationships. Buckle up, people. Get your seatbelt on. Strap yourself in. Because we're going to talk about relationships. But don't worry, I'm not going to go there on the whole sex thing. That'd be fun. Should we talk about that? Oh, no. We were talking about relationships. We can talk about sex. Sex matters to God. We can talk about sex another time. But living your best life and having a relationship. So I guess, like, when you hear the word relationship, some of you are thinking friendships. That was covered last week by those two awesome female preachers. Weren't they amazing? So relationships could be with your family, with your mum, your dad, your step-parents, your foster parents, your aunties, your uncles, your dog. I don't know. Relationships could also be like romantic ones. Maybe you're dating somebody. Maybe you have dated somebody. Maybe you would like to date somebody. Maybe somebody wants to date you and it's so super complicated. So how do we live our best life and have relationships that are not only good and healthy, but because we love Jesus, honour Jesus? Well, it is all about perspective, guys. And there's a brilliant verse in 2 Corinthians 1:16. Where Paul says this thing that if you've been around church for a while, you'll have heard this expression before. So sometimes it can lose its power for us, but it's like this amazing thing. Paul says, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit? And when I was a teenager, I really wanted a tattoo. And my mum pulled that line out all the time as a way of saying, don't get a tattoo because your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. I could never really like connect quite why getting a tattoo would do anything to the Holy Spirit. But I guess she had a point. Like I think you can be a Christian and get tattoos, absolutely. But I think the point she was trying to make was loving Jesus is not just what you do with your brain and your emotions. It's the decisions that you make and it's how you use your body and how you value your body and how you value other people's bodies and other people's emotions and other people's lives. I think that's what she was trying to get at. Or maybe she just didn't want me to like tattoo, I really fancy Brad, like across my arm, because actually I only fancied Brad for about 5 minutes. So I'm quite glad it's not there. But that thought that actually our bodies are a temple of the Holy Spirit, that God dwells within us, God lives in us, has implications. It means things about how we live our life and the decisions that we make, all of them, how we spend our money, what jobs we do, what we think about in terms of career, like justice issues. Do we get plastic? Do we recycle things? Do we care for the environment? Like all of that matters to God. And one area that I think can be quite complicated for us is the area of relationships. So here's some wisdom for you. Number one, the most important relationship you will ever have in your life, you already have if you know Jesus. God is your father. You are his daughter or son. Jesus is your brother. The Holy Spirit lives within you. Like, there is no other relationship on the planet that will fulfill you as much as that one. So you are already loved. Like, you are already somebody that somebody amazing wants to be with. Like, that's God and God is with you. And then when it comes to relationships, like dating people and going out with people, do you know dating doesn't appear in the Bible? Because in Bible times, people didn't go on dates. It just, nobody did. Like that wasn't the culture. So what we tend to see is people that are either single or they're married. But that doesn't mean that God hasn't got things to say about dating. So here's two things. Number one, be selfless. Like the way Jesus asks us to lay down our lives for each other, it's also about our dating relationships. Like, if you're going to go out with somebody, is it just about having a good time, having a bit of arm candy, someone that makes you look good? Or actually, are you going to see that relationship as your opportunity to be selfless, to be kind, to like really encourage them, to only go out with somebody who wants to do that to you too, to encourage you, to be kind to you, to be selfless, like to put your needs first. Like maybe they want to get like ice cream, but you want to go and get a kebab and they're willing to go and get a kebab because that's what you want to do. And maybe you say, actually, I'm a Christian, so I'm not going to be like doing anything around having sex until I'm married in that committed relationship. And they're like, yeah, I honour that too. And so we're going to be faithful together. And I'm going to be selfless and we're going to do it like that. Like, that's amazing, isn't it? Be selfless. Do you know, I can't remember number two. And the reason I can't remember number two is that I think I've summed it up, haven't I? Because Jesus says, love God with all your heart, soul and mind, and love your neighbour as you love yourself, which means any relationship that we are in, we need to love and treat that person in the way that Jesus loves and treats them. That we need to kind of express that kind of kindness and love. And also we can expect to be with somebody who does that to us. The number of times I've heard people say, I didn't want to do that in a relationship, but that person said to me that if I loved them, then I would do that for them. Guys, that's not love. Love is not like being manipulated into doing things that you don't want to do or not ready to do. Love is about saying, I really honour you, I really care for you, and I want this relationship to be good for you and to help you in your relationship with God. So lots of thoughts there, only 5 minutes. But you know what I love the most in my week is the Tuesday evening where we get to unpack some of these things. So I know Beth will be like, Rachel, give us a challenge for the week. Okay, here's a challenge. Number one, I'd like you to think of a dating relationship that you see around you, maybe a couple in church, it could be in your family, it could be in celebrity. And I want you to like write that, like think of, what do you really love about that relationship? What is it about that relationship that you think, I really want, I think Jesus loves that about their relationship. And if ever I'm in a relationship, I want it to be like that. And then I'd love you to have a thought about maybe a relationship, and it might sadly be like one that you've had or in your family or in celebrity culture or whatever it is, and you think, oh, that relationship, that was something that was, it didn't talk about the way God loves us. Like there was something about that relationship that was not good, not healthy. And maybe see if you can identify what that is. So this is not about blaming people or shaming people, but it's about recognizing, if I'm to love God with all my heart, soul and mind and love my neighbor as myself, and that includes dating relationships, what are the signs of that? What does that look like? And what are the sorts of things that are not going to be in those relationships? How's that? I'm now going to go and get my girl. And I'll see you all fabulous people very, very soon. Bye.
Father, we thank you that you created us to be in relationships with people. We bring before you all the different types of relationships that we have, and we ask that you will help us to put you at the center of them. Help us to be selfless in our relationships and put the other person first, and guide us to find relationships where we feel like the other person puts us first. Help us to understand how it looks to have healthy relationships and to live our best lives in them. Amen.
Thank you all so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed it and we hope you found that really helpful. We're hanging out again on Zoom this week, so if you want to get involved, DM us on our Instagram page at minster.youth and we'd love to tell you about what's coming up. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and we'll see you again soon. Bye!